This is a production of PBS 39.
This is a Tempo special report. Every year, about 16,000 Pennsylvania students drop out of high school.
I would say that one of the biggest challenges that our students face is poverty.
Poverty impacts 50% of urban students in our area.
We have two choices. We can continue doing just what we're doing and see America's children fail, or we can try and make a difference.
Jeffrey Canada has made a difference by creating the Harlem Children's Zone in New York City. Today, his $58 million program serves nearly 16,000 adults and children.
People find lots of excuses. They come from broken homes, they're poor, their parents are alcoholics. We won't accept any of those excuses.
The Harlem Children's Zone offers a holistic approach to ending the cycle of poverty one child at a time.
That's going to work in Appalachia. That's going to work on in Los Angeles. That's going to work in Lehigh Valley.
Recently, a group of community leaders went to Harlem to see firsthand how it works. Over the next 30 minutes, we'll learn more about the successful Harlem Children's Zone and see how some programs already in place here are starting to make an impact.
We see a full grade level increase in about 80% of our students that come.
Plus, we'll give you three ways every person watching this program can get involved in saving our kids.
Bringing the pieces together to make an impact is no small task, but it's what the United Way is all about. Lou Liebhaber, chairman of the board of the Greater Lehigh Valley United Way, joins us right now to talk a little bit more about it. Lou, thanks so much for your time.
Thank you, Amy, for having me.
Where do we start? Because after seeing this story with Jeffrey Canada and seeing some progress, it's hard not to want to start.
Yeah. It is an amazing thing that they've put together in Harlem, and we hope to do the same thing in the Valley in some fashion. And we've got to do this smart, so we put a study group together. That group visited Harlem, visited Jeffrey Canada's program. They understand the other programs in the Valley. And the study group will work over the coming 3-4 months to help determine where we start, what resources we need, and what timeline will be most effective to bring this program into the Valley.
One of the things that you and I were chatting about was a key component that could help this is having AmeriCorps volunteers. Help us understand what role they would play.
Yeah. So in the program in Harlem, which by the way has been up for almost 25 years, and it's only the last 10 years they've hit their stride, they relied heavily on AmeriCorps volunteers. They call them actually Harlem Peacemakers. And their job at the very beginning was going door to door in communities to engage families, to engage community members in improving their block, fixing street lights and locks on doors and taking some pride in their community. Today the peacemakers are teachers. They assist children walking safely from one school to another, back to their home. They fulfill a variety of needs. But the AmeriCorps volunteers were a critical resource to bring to Harlem to help create some order out of chaos, to help children learn, to create a sense of safety as well.
You also were talking that it may even take some creation of some new nonprofits in our area to help manage the extra resources necessary.
Yeah, so Amy, we have wonderful programs doing terrific things in the Valley. And part of the magic here will be to try to find ways to bring those programs together and focus on an area of our community to get it right, do everything that it takes to help children in an area be successful, and then to be able to grow that effort from one place to another. If we can find an organization that can pull all those pieces together, that would be ideal. And if a new entity has to be created to help serve as an umbrella, essentially, to convene the right resources, then that may be the answer as well. And the work of the study group will help us get that answer.
Now, there might be people concerned out there who have been funded by the United Way for many, many years, and they might be going, uh-oh, I fall out of this new parameter. Am I going to lose my funding? What type of concerns are there for folks who have been traditionally funded by the United Way in the past?
Yeah. So we have many good programs doing very good things in the Valley, and I would encourage them to keep doing that. The United Way, as you know, this past year has started a new strategic investment plan. That plan intends to focus resources on important community issues. So we have programs in the Valley that are already getting used to the concept of focusing on specific outcomes. And this will be just another area of sharpening that focus. So I don't think any programs have anything to worry about. Just continue to deliver great services. And as we convene an effort to focus on a community, that we hope that those existing programs will join hands with us to help make a difference in those communities.
And measuring outcomes. That's something that's very hot right now in the nonprofit world, that we need to be able to measure outcomes, but it's not always easy to measure those outcomes. Yeah. Are there any suggestions that, you know, where do you start with that?
Yeah, measuring outcomes is not easy, but it is critical. We want to know that the investments that this community makes in its spirit, in its resources, in its money, in its time, make a difference. And the critical difference is having children be successful and having children end up going to high school and college and coming back into this community and serving the community again and being productive members of our society rather than being locked up in jail and dropping out of society. And so the best measure will be a long-term measure of the health of this community. There are specific things, prenatal care as an example, healthy babies, having children ready for school. You know, when children get to third grade, if they're not reading on a third grade level, they're probably lost forever at young age. So there are very clear measures and steps along the way. And the other piece I'd say here, Amy, is that this is a long-term effort. These are long-term measurements. If there were a simple solution, everybody would be doing it. Right. These are difficult, intractable problems.
And there's no magic wand, but we've run out of time. Lou Liebhaber, Chairman of the Board of the Greater Lehigh Valley United Way, thank you so much for your time.
And thank you very much for doing this.